Welcome back to the Military Meditation Coach Podcast, your source for meditation, mindfulness, and relaxation exercises, made for the military, but good for everyone. I'm Dr. Julie Kinn with the Defense Health Agency, and today we once again feature Public Health Service Commander William MacNulty, Health Promotion Psychologist for the 1st Special Forces Group. This is part 3 in our 4-part series with Commander MacNulty. This time, he will lead us in a body scan practice. Before we go on to Commander MacNulty, let me remind you that the views expressed here are those of the presenters and do not reflect the official policy of the Department of Defense or the United States government. The Military Meditation Coach is produced by the Naval Center for Combat and Operational Stress Control and by the Defense Health Agency. Please do let us know what you think. Our email address is in the show notes. You can also contact us on social media. We are at Military Health, and our website is health.mil. Now on to Commander MacNulty.
Welcome to the practice of the body scan. Now, to begin this practice, it may be helpful to come to a comfortable seated posture, one that is upright and stable, that promotes a sense of ease and wakefulness in the body and the mind. Lowering or closing your eyes, whichever you'd prefer. And then bringing attention to the body seated in the chair in this moment. Noticing where the feet make contact with the ground, where the body makes contact with the chair, aware of the legs and the hips in contact with it, aware of the back, perhaps in contact with the back of the chair, aware of the body moving with the breath, and aware of the breath flowing through the body. And as we observe the sensations of breathing, we may notice that the breath is more prominent, more vivid in certain parts of the body, maybe the nostrils or the back of the throat, the chest, the belly. Wherever you're experiencing the breath most prominently and distinctly, allowing awareness to move right up close to that part of the body and observing the moment-to-moment sensations of breathing in very great detail, with as much depth and fullness as possible. And whenever we notice that our awareness has moved away from the breath, away from the body, it's been called away by a memory or a worry or some distraction, fantasy, what have you, just noticing this has occurred and then purposefully and patiently escorting awareness back to the body. And so from here, bringing awareness from wherever we're noticing the sensations of breathing, down the left leg, all the way down to the sole of the left foot, sensing into the experience of the left sole in this moment. Maybe sensing the contact with the ground, sensing temperature, maybe warmth or coolness. And then wrapping awareness around the sides of the left foot and over the top, all the way down to the toes. Just holding all of the left foot in awareness. And noticing what's going on in this moment in the left foot. And then bringing awareness up into the left ankle and the lower left leg from ankle to the knee. Noticing any sensations that are arising there, whether they're pleasant, unpleasant, or neutral. And whenever we notice that the mind has moved away from the body, just noticing this has occurred and gently but purposefully escorting awareness back to where we had placed it before, or to where the instructions are inviting us to place our attention now. Moving now to the left knee. And then up to the upper left leg from the knee to the hip. Sensing the feeling of fabric on skin, perhaps, the contact with the chair, and sensing into the large muscles of the upper left leg. And from here, expanding awareness to include all of the left leg, from the hip down to the toes, before releasing the left leg and moving awareness now to the sole of the right foot and expanding around the sides and over the top, down to the toes, and maybe even sensing into the skin between the toes of the right foot. Just holding all of the right foot in awareness. Sensations of tingling, of itching, of throbbing, of pulsing. Sensations of warmth, of coolness, moisture, dryness. Sensations we may call pleasant, unpleasant, or neutral, just kind of there. And maybe the absence of sensation. And that too is an experience that can be held in awareness. Moving now to the lower right leg, from ankle to the bottom of the knee. And then moving up into the right knee itself, the kneecap, the back of the knee, the spaces within the joint. Moving now up into the right thigh, the upper right leg, from knee to hip, from side to side, front to back, skin to bone. And then from here, expanding awareness to include all of the right leg, from hip to the toes. And allowing the right leg to recede from awareness as we become aware of the hips. Sensing into the contact with the chair below them. And then moving up into an awareness of the bones of the pelvis, this large vessel that's created by those bones, sensing into the organs contained within this vessel, beginning with the organs of reproduction, elimination, and sensing how these organs are connected above to the organs of digestion, and becoming aware of the heat and activity of the intestines, and sensing into all the other organs of the lower and upper abdomen. Becoming aware now of the upper part of the torso, the heart, and the lungs, each moving in its own rhythm. Feeling the expanding and receding of the abdomen with the breath. And becoming aware now of the heart, feeling the beating of the heart, and seeing if you can notice the distant echo of this beating and the pulses elsewhere in your body. And then allowing the lungs and the heart to continue each in their own rhythm. Moving awareness now to the low back, up into the curved part of the lower back, the muscles, the bones, noticing any sensations that are there, pleasant, unpleasant, or neutral, and allowing them to be just as they are. Noticing the mid-back, the upper back, aware of any tension or tightness there. And whenever we encounter tension in the body, we can invite it to soften. And if it doesn't soften, we can just allow it to be just as it is. And if we encounter any sensations that we might describe as unpleasant, as best we can, simply allowing them to be just as they are as well. Not trying to make this moment any different than it is. Moving awareness now to the shoulders and around to the chest. And then moving awareness to the upper left arm, from the armpit and the shoulder down to the elbow, and the elbow itself. Becoming aware of the left forearm and wrist, the left hand and fingers, right the way down to the fingertips. And then from there into the fingertips of the right hand. And then the right hand itself, the palm and the back of the hand, the right wrist and forearm, the elbow, the upper right arm, right up into the armpit and up into the shoulder. And from here, becoming aware of the neck, the throat, the tongue, and all that the tongue is in contact with right now. Perhaps the back of the throat, the roof of the mouth, the teeth, the jaw. And sensing the muscles connecting the jaw to the skull. And moving down the jaw to the very tip of the chin, the lips, the cheeks of the face. Just being aware of any sensations arising here and breathing with them, being present. Aware of the nose and the spaces behind the nose. Aware of the eyes. Aware of the temples and the sides of the head, the forehead. Maybe sensing the touch of hair on scalp. And from here, becoming aware of the ears, the folds of tissue and skin of the outer ears, and moving into the inner ear, passing through the eardrum, and by this route, moving right into the inside of the skull. Becoming aware of the brain itself. Just sensing into this exquisitely complex exchange of energy and information that makes up the most complex thing in the known universe. And each one of us has one. And sensing how this network extends downwards into the spinal column, and further still through the nervous system distributed throughout the body. And through this ongoing exchange of energy and information, we become aware of the experience of the scalp and the face, the head. We're connected to the throat and the neck, the shoulders and arms and hands. We become aware of the experience of the back, and the chest, the upper and lower abdomen, the hips, the legs, the knees. the feet and the toes. Now all of these distinct experiences are integrated into one complete and organic wholeness. And so, just breathing into the organic wholeness and completeness that is this body in this moment. And noticing the reality that everything we've experienced has happened to and through this body. And through it all, this body has moved towards health and wholeness to the best of its ability. And so, if you care to, just cultivating a sense of gratitude and appreciation for this body, just as it is, in all the many ways that it supports us to move purposefully through our lives. And then when you're ready, and with an awareness of doing so, opening the eyes or shifting the gaze, as we conclude this period of body scan practice.